Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm here to tell you what's out there in the movies. And, you know, I'm going to do Scumbag, and I'm going to get there, because everything from a major studio belongs in the scum bucket. But there are two small movies that are actually good, and I'm going to start with those first. The number one is called In the Loop. It stars James Gandolfini, and it's a political satire. It's a political satire that's almost like Dr. Strangelove. I mean, don't get your hopes up, it's not that good, but it's pretty damn good. And Gandolfini plays this kind of dovish general, if there is such a thing. And we're seeing, basically, without mentioning the Iraq War, we're seeing the stupidity that went up into the buildup of this war. So we have British politicians, and we've got a guy played by Peter Capaldi, who I really didn't know. There's a British TV series called The Thick of It. This guy curses up a storm. I've never heard the F word used so creatively since the last play by David Mamet. I'm not going to say anything more about it except to say that you will laugh, you will recognize all the people that are being played, and that this movie should have a fighting chance.
You're an idiot.
It'll be easy peasy lemon squeezy.
No, it won't. It will be difficult lemon difficult.
Ron Weasley.
John and Yoko.
Baby from Eraserhead.
The woman from The Crying Game.
The boy from The Shining.
Nazi Julie Andrews.
Seaside donkey.
You're a useless piece of S.
Star. Star T.
You got no idea where my balls have been.
What was with the homoerotic tension?
The other good small movie is called The Answer Man, and it stars another terrific actor, Jeff Daniels, who's on Broadway now in God of Carnage. And he's a guy named Arlen Faber who wrote a book once called Me and God, and became so famous, he became like J.D. Salinger, that he had to hide out, because the whole story of this book is questions that he asks God, and God gives him the answers. Sounds silly, but not silly. Funny, smart.
Oh, my back is out!
Try asking God for help!
Funny Smart is just not out there. And as I bring up the scum bucket and get it prepared, get all those Transformers 2, Revenge of the Fallen people together, going in to join you is a zero-star piece of crap romantic comedy called The Ugly Truth, starring Gerard Butler, who you remember from 300, and Katherine Heigl from Grey's Anatomy. The stupidity of this goes beyond any kind of chick flick horror. I mean, Katherine Heigl's producing a show in Sacramento, California. She's not getting ratings. Some boss hires Gerard Butler, who has a cable show where he uses every F word in the world, although nowhere near as imaginatively as the people do in the Loop. And they curse each other, and in one wonderful scene, which I think you could see in the trailer, she sits there wearing vibrator panties, and a little boy gets a hold of the control, and she sits and twitches at the dinner table while the little boy makes her panties vibrate.
Ceviche. It's...
Yeah, I'm gonna ask the chef for the recipe, please.
Abby, hold on. Tell Harold about the new teaser campaign we're starting next week. You...
What's in ceviche?
This is the level of the humor here. Crap, 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 crap. Turn around, it's all that. Orphan? Orphan with good actors like Vera Farmiga and Peter Sarsgaard? With the orphan, they adopt this child from an orphanage, and it turns out there is no orphanage. Where did she come from? Is it supernatural? Crap. The major crap they, of course, would not show me. And I'm going to go for you. I'm going on Friday or Saturday, and I'm going to report back to you. It is called G-Force. It is in 3D. It is produced by Jerry Bruckheimer, who does worse movies. Well, not worse, but movies on a par with those of Michael Bay. This time we have guinea pigs with voices of Nick Cage and Sam Rockwell and Penelope Cruz. What? Look at the trailer. Look at these. They're talking guinea pigs with star voices. It's so stupid, and they're doing espionage. They're spies. And you ask me why I'm recommending indie movies? Because this is the crap that's out there. So yes, put G-Force on the edge of the scum bucket, because I think it's going in before the weekend is out. But Ugly Truth, you're in there now.
So great.
And I'm Peter Travers.